Hello everyone, welcome to electronics lecture. As we know, this chapter instruments is devoted to three important measuring instruments: cathode ray oscilloscope, function generator and digital multimeter. Cathode ray tube is the central unit of cathode ray oscilloscope, and in our previous lectures we have studied internal structure of cathode ray tube and electrostatic focusing in cathode ray tube. Today we will be discussing about deflection systems in cathode ray tube. Two types of deflection systems can be used in cathode ray tube. One is electrostatic deflection system, in which electric field is used to produce the deflection of the electron beam. And second type is magnetic deflection system, in which magnetic field is used to produce the deflection of the electron beam. Now let us study electrostatic deflection system in detail. Now what is electrostatic deflection? Electrostatic deflection is a method of aligning the path of charged particles by applying the electric field between the deflecting plates. In the previous lectures, also while studying internal structure of CRT, we have seen there are two sets of deflecting plates in cathode ray tube: the vertical plate and horizontal plate. The vertical plate produces electric field in the horizontal plate and causes horizontal deflection, whereas the other pair is mounted horizontally and generates electric field in the vertical plane and causes vertical deflection. These two plates, horizontal and vertical, allow the beam to pass through the deflecting plates without striking them. And these plates are supplied with appropriate voltages that make out a pattern on the screen. This figure shows the general arrangement of electrostatic deflection system in cathode ray tube. It consists of two parallel plates, which is maintained at positive potential ET. These two parallel plates are separated by distance small d. As this is maintained at positive potential, uniform electric field is produced in between these two plates in y direction. Therefore, any electron entering in this field will experience a force in the y direction, and therefore it will be accelerated in that direction only, and there will be no force acting in either x direction or z direction. Now as such, there will be no acceleration of the electrons in this direction. Therefore, the electron after leaving this deflection plate, see this path, after leaving this deflecting plates, travel in a straight line path. This path is straight line path, and here this path is parabolic path. So this electron, after leaving this deflecting plates, travel in a straight line path and leaves its parabolic path. This is because the fact that it crosses the electric field that is influenced by its motion. And this straight line path is always tangent to the parabolic path. So we can see from this, whenever the electron beam remains within the electric field, the path is parabolic, and after leaving this electric field, the path of the electron becomes straight line path. Thus we can see, when electron leaves the region of the deflection plates here, there is no deflecting force, and therefore it travels in a straight line path towards the point P dash, on the fluorescent screen. These dotted lines are the lines of flux. These are called as lines of flux. This is parabolic path. This is straight path. Now, the amount of deflection which is produced on the screen depends on speed of the electrons, then voltage applied across the deflection plates, then size of the plate, and distance of the screen from the plates. In CRT, the accelerating potential, the size of the plates, and their distance from the screen are fixed. Particular CRT ke liye, ye elements kya hai, ye parameters kya hai, these all are fixed. Accelerating potential, and that's why speed of electron beam, size of plates, and distance from the screen are fixed. Therefore, the position of the spot speed dash, ye jo yahan pe deflection produce hua hai, on the screen, वो डिफ्लेक्शन किसके ऊपर डिपेंड है? तो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द वोल्टेज अप्लाइड टू द डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट्स ओनली. डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट्स पे जो हम वोल्टेज अप्लाई करते हैं, सिर्फ इसके ऊपर ही क्या है, ये पोजीशन ऑफ दिस स्पॉट पी डैश इज डिपेंडेंट. इसके बाद में बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर हम यहाँ पे डिफाइन करने वाले हैं, विच इज कॉल्ड एज डिफ्लेक्शन सेंसिटिविटी. डिफ्लेक्शन सेंसिटिविटी सीआरटी की. डिफ्लेक्शन सेंसिटिविटी क्या है? तो इट इज द रेशियो ऑफ डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द बीम ऑन द स्क्रीन इन मीटर पर यूनिट डिफ्लेक्शन वोल्टेज. यहाँ पे ये जो डिफ्लेक्शन सेंसिटिविटी है, it is denoted by letter S, which is equal to capital D divided by ED. D kya hai? Deflection of the beam on the screen. D measure karte hai meter mein, and deflection voltage is measured in volts. Therefore, the unit of deflection sensitivity is meter per volt, or we can also write it in millimeter per volt. D is deflection on the fluorescent screen and ED is the deflection voltage. अब electrostatically deflection system जो हमने देखी अभी, जिसके बारे में अभी हमने पढ़ा, उसका major application क्या है? तो ये deflection system CRTs में, cathode ray oscilloscope के CRTs में ये deflection system use होती है. Electrostatically deflected CRTs are used in cathode ray oscilloscope. Cathode ray oscilloscope में ही इसकी major application है. Now let us study magnetic deflection system in CRT. अभी हमने electric deflection system देखी है, अब हमें detail में study करना है मैग्नेटिक डिफ्लेक्शन सिस्टम. अब नाम से ही पता चलता है कि यहाँ पे क्या है, तो डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम इज कॉज्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. और मैग्नेटिक फील्ड यहाँ पे कौन प्रोड्यूस कर रहा है? जैसे हमने अभी देखा था कि इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक डिफ्लेक्शन सिस्टम में दो डिफ्लेक्टिंग प्लेट्स है, दो डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट्स है, एक है वर्टिकल डिफ्लेक्टिंग प्लेट एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल डिफ्लेक्टिंग प्लेट. वैसे मैग्नेटिक डिफ्लेक्शन सिस्टम में डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट्स नहीं है, लेकिन उसकी जगह पे क्या है, डिफ्लेक्शन कॉइल्स आर प्रेजेंट. यहाँ पे ये जो दिखाई गई है ये फिगर में, ये है डिफ्लेक्शन कॉइल्स. दीज आर द मैग्नेटिक डिफ्लेक्शन कॉइल्स. ये भी पेयर में होती है, यहाँ पे दिख रही है दो हॉरिजॉन्टल है और दो वर्टिकल है. यहाँ पे ये डिफ्लेक्शन कॉइल्स जो है, इट इज वाउंड ऑन एन असेंबली कॉल्ड एज योक. जिसके ऊपर ये वाउंड की होती है उसे योक कहते हैं, एंड इट इज प्लेस्ड नियर द नेक ऑफ द सीआरटी. ये जो पोर्शन है, ये पोर्शन को क्या कहते हैं, neck of CRT. Ye deflection coils are situated or are placed near the neck of CRT. One pair is for horizontal deflection and second pair is meant for the vertical deflection. यहाँ पे ये जो deflection coils है, ये coils से जब current flow होता है, तो ये region में क्या होता है? Uniform magnetic field is produced. An electron beam produces circular magnetic field around it. This can be seen from this figure. When uniform magnetic field is made to interact with this field, the magnetic lines of force, these are the magnetic lines of force. Magnetic lines of force are distorted and the beam is deflected as shown in this figure. By reversing the poles of the external magnetic field, the beam can be moved in upward direction also. जो फिगर हमने यहाँ पे स्टडी की थी वहां पे क्या देखा था हमने कि बीम का जो डिफ्लेक्शन है दैट वाज इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. तो अगर पोलैरिटी एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड की रिवर्स करते हैं तो बीम की डायरेक्शन जो है वो अपवर्ड भी कर सकते हैं. दिस अमाउंट ऑफ डिफ्लेक्शन इज प्रपोर्शनल टू द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विच इज प्रपोर्शनल टू द current in the coil. In this reference also we can define magnetic deflection sensitivity as the amount of deflection of the electron spot caused by magnetic flux density of 1 Weber per meter square. Unit of magnetic deflection sensitivity can be meter per Weber per meter square. Weber per meter square is Tesla. So meter per Tesla is the unit of magnetic deflection sensitivity. These magnetically deflected CRTs are generally used in radar indicators and in television picture tubes. यहाँ पे हमने जो electrostatic deflection system और magnetic deflection systems जिनके बारे में पढ़ा उनका जो mathematical डेरिवेशन पार्ट है वो आपके स्कोप ऑफ सिलेबस में नहीं है इसलिए हमने यहाँ पे वो कवर नहीं किया है. तो अगर पूरा इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक एंड मैग्नेटिक डिफ्लेक्शन सिस्टम ये कंपैरेटिव स्टडी अगर हम करते हैं तो वी कैन से इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक डिफ्लेक्शन सिस्टम यूजेस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड टू प्रोड्यूस द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम एंड मैग्नेटिक डिफ्लेक्शन यूजेस current carrying coils to produce magnetic field. In case of electrostatic deflection, amplitude of deflection is directly proportional to the accelerating voltage of the electron beam, whereas in magnetic deflection, the amplitude of deflection is directly proportional to the square root of the accelerating voltage of the electron beam. In electrostatic deflection, size of electron beam is smaller as compared to magnetic field and the length of the tube is larger as compared to the magnetic deflection. The brightness of the display in electrostatic deflection is quite low as compared to that of magnetic deflection. And electrostatic deflection system is used in CRO and magnetic deflection system is generally used in picture tube of television. I hope you have understood electrostatic and magnetic deflection system. Thank you very much for watching.